Hi, welcome to this part of my review featuring A Wicked Secret. This is a collection of scenarios, specifically 4 scenarios, that you can play using the Vazen role-playing game. If you haven't seen the other parts of this review and my review of the core rulebook, please check out the playlist in the description below. In this case, we are talking about the Night Sow scenario, and this of course is going to contain spoilers, so keep that in mind. So this scenario features an important part of the history of the society, Linnea Elfeklint. Many of you remember that Linnea was the one who introduced the characters to the society, and she is going to ask help on behalf of an old acquaintance that used to belong to the society. However, there are many more things to this mystery. By the end of the entire affair, the player characters will have to handle Satanists, Puritans, and a Vazen that feeds on people's supernatural powers. Now let's talk about the background of this scenario. In the northwest part of Skan, in southern Sweden, a strange rock formation rises. This area is known as the Hill, and at its tip stands an ancient lighthouse. For hundreds of years, the eldest son of the London family has served as its keeper. The Londons believe they have a secret. The hill was created by the devil, and there is always a danger of wicked creatures emerging from its caverns and ravines. It is the duty of the lightkeeper to hold off this evil and prevent ignorant humans from accidentally channeling the black magic of the underworld, which could potentially bring about the apocalypse. What the family doesn't know is that it is their own belief that is creating the Vazen on this hill, and making spells and rituals particularly effective in the area. Likewise, the Lightkeeper's own magic is a product of this belief in his sacred mission. The current Lightkeeper is Magnus London, who in recent years has seen the once isolated The Hill and its small fishing village of Mull become thronged with tourists from the rest of the country, as well as from Denmark and Germany. The reason for this is that an entrepreneur by the name of Katarina Johnson, who a few years ago built a luxurious seaside hotel in Mull and is encouraging her guests to bathe together at the beach, is the center of the worries, the concerns of both the lightkeeper and the local priest. They think it is a sin for her to have this sort of resort with a beach where both men and women enjoy the waters. Now, the residents of Mull do not mind this too much because it is good for the economy of Mull, but the priest thinks this is a sin, and the lightkeeper believes that it is somehow empowering or fueling the dark powers of the hill. The lightkeeper even tried to burn down this hotel, but he was caught by the authorities. But this, of course, did not deter the lightkeeper from other plans to stop this sinful occurrence in the hotel. That same summer, the hotel was visited by Olga Kraus, a former member of the society and an acquaintance of Linnea Elfeklint. Now, Olga left the organization 20 years ago to learn magic through contacts with satanic cults. She has since surrounded herself with a group of women who share her ambition. They call themselves the Sisters of Satan. When others are around, they often pretend to be a group of traveling artists. During her visit to Mull, Olga stumbled upon a cave near the hill lighthouse and sensed that it was a well-suited place for magical rituals. Little did she know that this was the Rooting Cave, a place where the Glossen, the Vazen that appears in this scenario, can take form if someone performs the necessary rituals. Olga left Mull only to return with the other Sisters of Satan a few months later, when the tourist season was over. They started investigating the Rooting Cave and planned to perform a magical ritual. Realizing that these sisters were up to no good, the Lightkeeper London decided to get rid of them and Katarina Johnson at the same time. By kidnapping Katarina's dog Costa and luring her with magic, he drew her to the Rooting Cave. He attacked her, tied her up, and locked her in a cage in the back of the cave. Magnus prepared her body so that a Glossen could use it to take form. When Olga and her sisters gathered in the Rooting Cave, the ritual they performed created magic energy that soaked into Katarina's body and turned her into a Glossen. The creature broke out of its cage and attacked the witches, but they made it back to the hotel unharmed. Magnus is now controlling the creature with the help of a linden staff, and he intends to use it to kill these sisters. He has the Glossan wait outside the hotel to attack them if they ever try to leave. Olga understands that they cannot leave the hotel and sent a desperate letter to her old friend in the society, Linnea Elfeklint. Linnea asks that the player characters go to Mull to help her. So the Glossan was summoned on the hill. It is called the Night Sow. It sprung into being as the Lightkeeper Magnus Lunden lured Katarina Johnson to the Rooting Cave. Effectively, Katarina is the Night Sow. And this beast is waiting until the sisters step out of the hotel, and it is ready to attack others by the orders of Lunden. The Night Sow actually hates Lunden, but she cannot do anything about him because he has control over the Night Sow. The atmosphere of this adventure is quite creepy. As the player characters carry out their investigations, they are constantly feeling as if they are being spied upon or watched from the shadows. This is probably the Night Sow or Lunden. Now, there are some major conflicts in this scenario. The primary conflict is between the Night Sow and Lightkeeper Magnus Lunden, who is trying to control it. And the secondary conflict is regards Mull's approach to its summer tourists. Lightkeeper Magnus, Chaplain Algot Kransvik, and the fisherman's wife Anna Svensson are the main proponents of preserving the community's virtuous reputation and tearing down the hotel, while Katarina Johnson, Anna Svensson's daughter by the name of Lisa, and a couple of others believe that Mull should welcome the tourists. So Linnea Elfeklint will receive this letter from Olga. She cannot leave the hotel, but she managed to get this letter through, and she is asking for Olga's help. She will talk to the player characters and show them the letter, which mentions some disturbing events that happened in the past concerning the society. However, Linnea is not willing to talk about these past events. So the player characters, because they feel indebted or connected to Linnea, will go to Olga's aid. They can research things beforehand, of course, obtain some clues in Uppsala. Perhaps they find a newspaper article about the scene in Mull. Or perhaps by researching the texts and documents of the society, they could stumble upon a paragraph in a nearly 50-year-old list of society activities describing the magic energies resting inside the hill. Once the player characters arrive at Mull, they won't be greeted by Olga. They will pick up their luggage and head towards the hotel. But on the way, they will find Olga's corpse lying in the ground next to an oil lantern. She tried to make her way out of the hotel, but she was viciously killed by the Night Sow. She has been torn open completely and her entrails have been devoured. So this marks a very disturbing beginning for the scenario. So now the player characters need to decide if they want to investigate the hotel or talk to the inhabitants of Mull first. You have details concerning all of the notable locations of this scenario. For example, there is the hill. The hill is a peninsula in northwestern Skan, where the bedrock has risen from the land, jutting up to form high cliffs and little bays with beaches along the coast. Further inland, the landscape is more dramatic, with crevices, caves, and ravines. Everything is covered by dense, deciduous forest that harbors a great variety of fauna. Then we have information on Mull. Mull consists of roughly 100 buildings constructed in a semicircle around the harbor. Most of them wooden gingerbread style houses, 1.5 stories tall, with a small top floor being used as a bedroom. The buildings climb the steep slope, and 10 lavish villas have recently been built at the top. That is where the owner of the hotel, Katarina Johnson, resides, or used to reside. Then, of course, we have information on Countdown and Catastrophe. This mystery has two countdowns. The first concerns the Night Sow attacking the Sisters of Satan, and eventually the player characters. The second is about the Lightkeeper spying on and then attacking the player characters. You have to use the events that fit the story. The Night Sow's countdown involves the death of several people. This Night Sow countdown occurs in three steps. The Night Sow kills one of the Sisters of Satan and gorges on her entrails. and the Night's Owl later on uses the enchantment Phantom Light to create light, luring out and killing another sister. And in the third step, the Night's Owl kills the last remaining sister, a woman named Frida, or Sangrina. Then, it is going to attack the player characters. It is going to make the player characters as its main target. And this marks the catastrophe. When the player characters are facing off against this Vasen, they have to defeat it somehow. Now, when it comes to the Lightkeeper's countdown, this also occurs in three steps. First, the Lightkeeper uses the enchantment Tempest. A great storm darkens the sky with icy rain and snow. The winds make it difficult to walk the slippery paths. The Lightkeeper uses the darkness to spy on the player characters. Then the Lightkeeper employs the curse Twist Vision on one of the player characters. If the curse succeeds, the character perceives one of the villagers as having glowing eyes and pig's tusks in her mouth. So this is going to work as a sort of derailment or red herring to move the characters away from the true curse to the source of the mystery, the Night's Owl. So this could end up quite bad for the player characters depending on how they act on this effect of the curse. Then on the third step, the Lightkeeper uses the curse Lure to compel one of the player characters to sneak out alone on the hill where the Night's Owl will attack that character. Now when it comes to catastrophe, the Lightkeeper uses the enchantment Ignite to set fire to several parts of the hotel, preferably while the player characters are inside the building. Then we have more details on locations. There are three locations for the player characters to visit: Olga's room at the Mall Seaside Hotel, the Rooting Cave, and the Chapel. When it comes to the Mall Seaside Hotel, it is located in the north part of Mall. It is newly built and spectacular, a white wooden three-story building with gingerbread detailing and towers with parapets. The porch offers a marvelous view of the sea. And because this mystery happens during winter time, there aren't too many people around. The building is quite empty and quiet. The ground floor houses a restaurant, a library, and a lounge, while two upper floors have rooms for guests and staff. Only a small part of the house is heated during the winter, and the entire business operation is run by the proprietor, Katarina Johnson, and her helper, Lisa Svensson. The people present at the time of the player character's arrival are Lisa Svensson, who works for Katarina Johnson, of course, and three remaining sisters of this satanic cult, and a handful of German tourists. Since the events at the Rooting Cave, the sisters have moved all their beds into a single room. And Olga's room contains two beds, a closet, a bookcase with 10 or so occult volumes on its shelves, and a desk covered by sheets of paper with maps and notes about the hill and its magic powers. Hanging in the closet are four black hooded robes, and there is a shelf with two black candles and two figurines. And of course, the group of investigators can try to gather clues in this hotel. Lisa can tell the characters that the proprietor of the hotel, Katarina Johnson, went missing 10 days ago after heading for the hill to look for her dog, Costa. Since Katarina's disappearance, Olga and other artists have seemed unusually nervous. If the characters ask Lisa about Moll, she describes the conflict surrounding the hotel, including how she went against her mother Anna Svensson, who wants the hotel demolished. And these are just some of the things that the characters can find here. For example, on the desk in Olga's room lies a hand-drawn map that shows the way to the Rooting Cave. In the margin, Olga has written, "Extremely charged with arcane potential, portal to hell." So the characters can make some sense of things here. There are also some challenges to be dealt with here. The Sisters of Satan are not likely to trust the player characters and maintain their facade as artists. The characters will have to use their manipulation, stealth, vigilance to try to pierce through the mystery concerning this satanic cult. You have information on all of the relevant characters of the adventure, of course. You have details on Lisa Svensson, on the sisters themselves, and you also have details on different documents that the characters can encounter throughout the course of this scenario. Now, when it comes to details concerning the Rooting Cave, in the north part of the hill lies the Rooting Cave, a place where a Glossen can be summoned. The cave has been used by witches for hundreds of years and is well known to the Lightkeeper. There is a path leading to the cave, which is located deep down a ravine, full of loose rocks, slippery ice and snow, and grasping branches. Because Vasin is a somewhat semi-realistic sort of experience, the characters may end up injured or dying as they are trying to make their way through the wilderness, you never know. In the center of the room inside of this cave, the sisters have drawn a pentagram in chalk. There is a human skull with a hole drilled into the top of the head, where several incense sticks have been inserted, and a plate of dried pig's blood has been placed in the middle of the pentagram. The characters can try to gather clues here as well, of course. For example, they can try to decipher an inscription on the wall that reads, "The rooting cave. The powers of the swine shall amass and consume the seeing. With linden and nut, the sow shall be mut." The player characters searching near the wooden cage within this place could pass an investigation test to find bits of torn rope and a cloth gag with dried saliva and blood on it. When it comes to challenges here, even with the map from Olga's room, getting to the cave through the snow of the hill is extremely strenuous and takes several hours each day. The characters will have to make some agility and force-related tests to reach this place successfully. When it comes to Mule Chapel, this chapel is located in the south. It has a hilly and partially overgrown graveyard where the night sow hides during the day. The chaplain Algot Kransvik lives in a small stone house next to the chapel, along with four cats and three dogs, as well as a tame crow that often sits on his shoulder, cawing threateningly at strangers. Algot will gladly welcome the player characters and invite them over for tea. The chaplain can tell them about the conflict surrounding the hotel. He suspects that Katarina is dead, as she has been missing for more than a week, but cannot imagine that someone in the village would go so far as to harm her. However, it seems to him that Lightkeeper Magnus Lundin hates the hotel more than anyone, and last summer he was caught trying to burn it down. The authorities in Helsingborg intervened, and the only reason Magnus was not convicted was that the chaplain put in a good word for him. The chaplain has also spotted the night sow on the outskirts of the village, and is convinced that the creature was sent from hell to punish Mull for its sins. When it comes to challenges here, Chaplain Algot is kind to strangers, but it takes a lot to gain his trust. You will need to make some manipulation tests to get something more out of him. When it comes to the confrontation of the scenario, this will most likely take place at the Hill Lighthouse. The player characters can have several reasons for visiting the lighthouse. They may have noticed Magnus Lundin spying on them, and they became suspicious perhaps. Or maybe the characters just got a bit curious about the lighthouse itself. Magnus is concerned when he sees the player characters approach the lighthouse. He uses his linden staff to summon the night sow, who comes running and hides nearby. If the player characters start acting aggressively, he commands the creature to attack them. If someone knocks on the door, the lightkeeper shows up with his staff in hand. He rudely tells the player characters to leave as he does not want visitors. If the player characters enter the lighthouse, the night sow will wander around outside, waiting for them, ready to attack. The night sow is even ready to break down the door and come for them, if they present a greater threat for the lighthouse keeper. Realizing that the player characters are onto him, Magnus attacks them with the curse's terror and wound, and then he will try to retreat up the lighthouse, where he uses his linden staff to attack the player characters, while at the same time using curses as well as his pistol. Breaking the linden staff actually cancels the magic that created the night sow, and reverts it to its original form, as Katarina Johnson. A player character who seizes the staff is able to control the creature, but the magic only works on the hill. A player character attacked by the night sow can easily be broken and killed. If the player characters decide to investigate the lighthouse before or after the main conflict, they may find a trapdoor to the basement. Down there, the lightkeeper keeps a larder, a chair and a desk, occult books, and Katarina Johnson's kidnapped dog, Costa, trapped in a wooden cage. If the player characters manage to save Katarina, they will have earned her eternal gratitude, and they will always be welcome at her seaside hotel. At the end of this scenario, you have full details on the Glosson, which is basically a giant sow with huge tusks eyes glowing like burning coals, and razor-sharp bristles on its back. Sparks fly from its hooves as it moves, and its grunts can be heard from afar, except when it opts to sneak up on a victim. The Glossan can instinctively sense whether or not a human has the sight or magic abilities. It tries to cut open their bodies, with the bristles on its back, in order to feast on their bowels. Remember, this Vassan, as stated at the beginning of this review, feeds on the magical energies of others. You have all of its stats, its magical powers, and the ritual that is used to summon it. And this concludes this part of the review. As you can see, this is a very creepy scenario. You do not exactly know what is going on. Looking at it from the perspective of the player characters, they arrive to this place trying to help a former member of the society without suspecting that that member is actually an enemy. And when it comes to Night's Owl, it is a tragic tale of someone transformed into a Vassan because of the evil actions of this Puritan lighthouse keeper that is actually the true evil sorcerer of this story. So a very atmospheric tale, perfect to run it during winter time because it happens during winter. And because of the lethality of the Night's Owl and the difficulties in investigating the background of the sisters, of the lighthouse keeper, of Merle itself, this is a very challenging scenario indeed. Thanks for watching this part of the review. If you have any comments or questions, please let me know. I hope you will watch part 4. The link to the playlist will be in the description below. In that part, I am going to review the final scenario and will give you my final thoughts on this collection of scenarios. And thank you so much to those of you that have been supporting the channel by sending Drive-Thru RPG gift certificates. If anyone else wants to further support the channel, the information on how to do that will be in the description below. Once again, thank you, and see you later!